So good morning class. Today we have seen the introduction of machine learning and what are the basic types of machine learning. So the machine learning is broadly divided into the three types. Okay, supervised machine learning, unsupervised, and the reinforcement learning. And based on this type of learning, we can say that if you have the labeled data, so you are you can apply the supervised learning algorithm. If you have the unlabeled data, so you can use the unsupervised data, machine learning algorithm. And if your system is adjusted itself according to the environment, so you can say that it is a reinforcement learning. So basically these are the three different types. Okay. So we start from the supervised learning. So all of you know that for the definition for supervised learning is that a supervised learning learning algorithm, they are learned under the some supervision. Under the some supervision means here that supervision is means that there is already labeled data, and on the basis of that labeled data, your algorithm has take some decision, or they understand the data and they will give some prediction or the output, or you can say that your algorithm is get model trained. Okay, so let us consider here one of the example, and through this example we will try to understand the supervisor. So I have the one given set of data with the features x1 x2 x1 up to the xn, and my targeted feature is y. So there is some input data, we have to say x1, x2, x3 and xn. From that I will give the prediction, that is y. Okay, so what is that? So let us consider I have the data of temperature, one of the different cities in India. So we can say that Mumbai, then Delhi, Nagpur, Aurangabad, okay, Ahmednagar, any city. So this is a city name, that is x1. Then city name is my x1 value. Then temperature, that is x2 of that particular city, is my x2. In x3 I am maintaining the time. At x4 I am maintaining the time, and x5 you can say that it's a duration of it, means it is it a morning duration, is it a afternoon duration, is it a evening duration, or is it a night duration. So let us consider I am storing this all information with an input feature in my data set. Okay, so what we have, we have the data with a different feature, and in the feature we are storing a data, for example city name, then the city, current temperature, current date, current time, and month, and session. So is it a morning session, is it a afternoon session, is it a evening session, or is it a night session. So from this data I would like to give the some prediction, and that prediction is nothing but my value y. Okay, so from this value x1 x2 x3 x4 x5 I'm giving the some prediction, my target value, that is my y. So we can say that from this data you are giving the prediction, tomorrow's city temperature prediction. Okay, so what we require? We require the current temperature, past temperature of that particular city, and at which station that city is get temperature is get high or temperature is get low. So if you have that historical data, if you have that past event data with you in the form of a data set, okay, so you can use some output that is called as a target feature. Okay. The set of the training example where the value for the input feature and the target feature are given for the each example. Each example where only the value for the input feature are given, and the predicting the value for the target feature for the new example. So in classification, if you consider the supervised machine learning algorithm under the term by using various classification algorithms, so that y is a discrete value. Okay, so why, what is the why you are given, or your model will be given, that is a discrete. Okay, what is the discrete? I simply say that it is yes, no, okay, tall or short. So if there is a binary value, you can say that if it is a binary value, so probably it's called a discrete. Okay, But if you are considering the any regression problem of supervised learning, so that is called as a continuous learning. Okay. So what is the concept of you? If you want to give the prediction of price in one of the locations, so that value is not a yes and no, or value is not a you can say that it is a binary. It is a continuous value. So you will like to say that the price of that particular house may be at 25 lakh, 26 lakh, is like this. Okay. You cannot give the prediction of that price in a yes or no condition. Okay. But the in weather prediction condition, you can give the Y as a target feature as a yes or no. If tomorrow will be the rain, yes or no. You can give that. Okay, yes. Tomorrow definitely there is a rain. Tomorrow there definitely there will be a no rain. So that is called as a classification, and that the targeted value we are giving here is nothing but your discrete value. But in a regression, the whatever the value you are giving as a output or prediction, that is not a yes or no, or it is not a binary value. It is a continuous value. Okay. Same thing. When you have a prediction of the stock market, so in a stock market also this value is a continuous value. It is not a discrete value. So you can see that the prediction, you may see that the tomorrow's stock market will be raised by 20%, 25% or 16%. Okay. You cannot say that the market will be rise or yes or no only. Okay. So these are some example of classification and the regression. So moving towards the some of the practical approach of this. So let's consider I am taking this example with a simple example to understand exactly what mean by the supervised learning or how the supervised learning is work. So here I replacing the input feature, and these input feature are called as x1, x2, x3, x4 and the xn, and this value, there is the value they this column, okay, it has, or the feature it has, there is a1, a2, a3, a4 up to an, b1, b2, b3, bn, okay, c1, c2 up to the cn, then the b1, b2, b3 up to the bn. And from this value, I am getting the value, targeted value, that is y, that is y1, y2, y3, y4, and so on. So if you say that this y is a discrete value, so you can say there is a classification problem. Okay, so that classification, rain today or not? Rain tomorrow? Yes or not? Yes or not? Okay, so this is a discrete value. And if y is a continuous value feature, then you can call it a regression problem. So the regression problem is house price prediction system. So in house price prediction system, your model will give some value that the price of that particular flat will be 25,000, or it may be 26,000 like this. Okay, it gives us some range. So it is not given only the one value. So that is called the regression value, or that is called the classification. So instead of that, let us consider this more practical example. Let us consider that this is an data set of one of the class 12 standard students maths. Okay. So in a 12th, you know that there is some math subject, the physics, chemistry, and English. So I am taking this 4 subject only here for considering our example. Okay. So let us consider I1, I2, I3. These are the instances. Okay. This is called the instances of your data set. So in my data set, I have the features like the math, physics, chemistry, and the English. And the instances are I1, that is a 28 marks, 35 marks, 40 marks, and 38 marks. I2 having the marks 37, 41, 35, 33, and so on. Like the I4 is a 22, 10, 33, 29, and the 23. Okay, so this is a data set, and in the data set, if you have such type of marks, so you will be passed or the fail. So who is the pass? Who having the marks, math 28, 35, 40, and 38, he is the pass. Instance 2 is also passed, instance 3 is failed, instance 4 is failed. I don't know why he failed, because there is some value. Let us consider I3 having the minimum very less mark, that is a 20 mark in chemistry, so he gets failed. Okay, so he gets failed in chemistry, so his result is failed. So there is some reason, that's why I3 and I4 are failed. Let us say. Now, what is my concern here? So let us consider there is one student, okay, X student, I call it the X student, and if he has a mark like this, 33, 43, 38, and 28, so is it that student is pass or fail? So how we can predict this? So this comes under the supervised learning, okay. Why? Because we already have the level data. So you can be say that the 33 mark is a chemistry mathematic mark, 43 mark are the physics mark, 38 mark from the chemistry mark, and 28 mark is got in the English mark. So this data has already a label data. So it is a label data. So from this label data, now I would like to find out the result. Is it his pass or fail? So this is a you can say it is a kind of classification. Okay, so either he can be pass or either he can be fail. So you can use any algorithm here. You can use any different supervised machine learning algorithm of classification, and from this you can predict that if you have such kind of data, if you have such kind of mark in your mark sheet, so you will definitely the pass or you will definitely the fail. Okay, so this kind of anybody can tell me is it he. What about the result? So is this student is pass or is this student is fail? How can we say? Yes, anybody can give you the prediction? A manual prediction, I am not saying that you have to implement the algorithm or anything. So can it possible this student is pass? Okay. Ashish Koteja, can you give me an answer? If the student having the 33, 43, 38 and 28, is the student is pass or fail? Yes, Ashish Koteja is there?
Pass.
Why?
Fail.
Who said that? Who said that a fail and who said that a pass? Okay, I'm just asking. No, I'm not saying that you are implementing algorithm and your answer will be. So, you can.
Your label, the data is labeled pass or fail.
No. The data is labeled, that is different thing, Ashish. That is, your data set has a labeled data set. So it is come under, so for to checking this problem is supervised or unsupervised, you can say that here, yes, this problem is come under the supervised machine learning algorithm because this data is a labeled data. But from this, you cannot say that this student is passed. Now?
The second way is like by taking average of four subjects.
Okay, so can you calculate this within 2 minutes? Can you calculate only the four instances averages? What is the instance average of the I1?
Just a
minute. Huh, a calculator low. Everybody, I will ask anyone. Yeah, someone want to share. Yes? So it has been yes, bol raha hai. Fail bol raha hai. Kisne kaha tha fail?
Yes, sir, 35.25.
What is that? For I1. So you can calculate all the, all, for all. I1, I2, I3, I4. Yes, Atharva Shirkar?
Yes, sir.
What is your opinion? Is this student is pass or fail? If he has a 33, 43, 38.
Very close, so can't say, but probably it could be pass.
It could be a pass.
One of it is in 20s.
Okay. Yes, again, anyone? See, after implementing this algorithm, obviously the student is passed. Now I'm telling you why. So if you see carefully, that is called the data reading. So you must be have a habit of how to read the data. Okay. So if you carefully see this data set, so let us see the passed student data. So minimum in two only, okay, I1 and I2. I1 and I2 are the pass, is it right? Okay, so let us consider the minimum mark of I1 and I2. Okay, so can anybody have a chat with me? Yeah, Deep. Yes, Deep Malviya, are you there? Hello, Deep Malviya? Yeah, Selvin? Selvin is there? Hello? Am I audible? Yes, Levin? Hello? You are not audible, Levin. Okay, no problem. Yeah. Rugved Kolle? Rugved? Kaustubh Shah. Kaustubh Shah is there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Kaustubh. So let us chat with me. So in I1 and I2, these two instances are passed. Is it correct? Kaustubh, don't mute yourself. You okay?
Comments is going on, sir.
Sorry?
Yes, sir.
So I1 and I2 are the, these two students are passed. Okay, now you can find out the minimum value from the I1 and I2. What is the minimum value you can find out?
28.
Okay, so that's good. So you can see that 28 is the minimum value, and now come to the I3 and I4.
Yes, sir.
So what is the minimum value?
22.
22, 20 only. See, I3 in chemistry have only the 20 marks.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So somewhere there is a some value on the basis of that you can say that you can take a mean value or medium value that if this student having this mark from any subject. So let us consider the 25 mark. So any student having a mark less than 25 mark in either the math, physics, chemistry and English, you can roughly say that this student is failed in whole market. Okay. So, but in our case, the student having the mark 33, 43, 38 and 28. So 28 is the minimum value you can see here, and the 28 is the minimum value you can see is the I1 math. Okay. So these two value are get us similar, but this I1 is passed. So from this you can probably, okay, I am saying it manually, I am doing all these things manually, I am not implementing any algorithm here. Okay, so manually I am saying that, okay sir, if this student is passed because he has a 33 mark, he has a 43 mark, 38 mark and the 28 mark, as the 28 is the lowest mark for this student, X student, and in the data set, if you consider, if you see him carefully, in class category, the minimum mark is 28. So obviously this student is passed, and that's the correct answer that his student, his result is passed, he is not failed. Okay, you can check using different supervised learning machine learning algorithm. You can use any classification algorithm. So definitely you will get the result that his student is passed on this. He is not a fail. Okay, so this is called as a supervised. Bottom line of this example is that how you understand the supervised learning. Okay, so in a supervised learning, you must have the labeled data. So in my data set, you can see that these are the features, these are the attributes, math, physics, chemistry, and English. These are the labeled data, okay, of different instances. So these are the instances like I1, I2, I3, and I4. And according to that, there is a target value. Okay, the target value is Y, right? And as it is come under the discrete format, that is a pass or fail only. So this is a type of classification. It is not a regression problem. Okay. So from this data set, you are getting all this information, and then you can find out, okay, if this is data, so I will apply the classification problem, and now I will predict that if the student having this mark, so he is pass or. So very simple. Okay, so this is called as a supervised learning. I hope all of you know understand what is a supervised learning and how to solve the supervised machine learning algorithm. Okay.